Keeping one step ahead, we hear from thought leaders on accounting in the digital age. The power of patterns, how data can be today's most valuable decision-making tool. And the hidden cost of IT when it's not fit for purpose. Hello and welcome to Data, Deluge and Decisions, a programme where we look at how accounting is being transformed in the digital age. I'm Natasha Kaplinsky. In partnership with the Chartered Institute of Management Accountants, we bring you reports on how management accounting, financial accounting and business focus are delivering sustainable success. First up, though, reporter Nick Wallace spoke to Andrew Harding, Chief Executive Management Accounting at the Association of International Certified Professional Accountants, about decision-making in a data deluge.
Accounting can sound dry, it can sound, you know, it can sound very conservative, but actually this is leading-edge business decision-making stuff. It's not just about numbers, it's not just about pounds and pence, dollars and yen. It's about measuring all kinds of things that matter to business, and it's about planning for future success as opposed to looking back at the past.
Tell me how management accountancy assists decision making at executive level.
We're living in this world now where all the talk is about big data, the information that we have, with questions being quite rightly raised about the veracity of that data. The management accountant is really there to not only own the data and to present the data in a way it can be digested, but also to use that data to provide the insights that enable business leaders to take the right decisions for the future.
So making the right decision and being able to communicate that effectively is using all the skill sets of a management accountant in this context.
Management accounting brings all of those things into play. You know, the intuitive business leader is still really important. Having that understanding of your customer, that understanding of the market is absolutely great. How do we get that into action? Equally though, how do we also align our other data to either support that intuitive view or to challenge that intuitive view? Those are both key parts going forward. There have been as many great intuitive decisions made as they have bad intuitive decisions made. You know, great business leaders have actually crashed their businesses on many occasions, having made them successes.
I guess it's important not just to understand the numbers and be able to analyse them properly, but to communicate the information within them to fellow executives and the wider company.
When we look at skill sets, we see that the technical skills are probably just a quarter of the piece. Add to that business acumen, leadership, and what you've just said, communication. You know, if you're going to provide decision-relevant information, you've got to be in the position to make that information not only digestible, but also influential. And that's where communication comes in. That's where leadership comes in. You know, increasingly, as the world becomes automated, those skills become more and more important, and in people's careers, that's what differentiates the best from the rest.
To what degree do management accountants have to have an eye on the future, thinking about the way companies and the industrial environment is going to change?
They need to be aware of what the opportunities are. They need to be aware of what the threats are, and no more so than around technology. We talk about increasing robotization. We talk about how that will affect clerical jobs, how that will affect finance jobs. But when we go out and talk to management accountants about that, they see opportunity. You know, 75% of our members that we talk to about technological change say this means we can do our jobs better because it will free us up from those mundane tasks to be able to provide better insight, to provide better leadership. So understanding those things, understanding where the opportunity lies, is crucial. I think, you know, if you come to it understanding where the threat lies, that doesn't really take you very far. But being able to drive those, you know, see those opportunities and drive the value from them helps not only the individual, but it helps the business to fulfil its potential and to stay ahead.